Hello, denizens of the internet. I'm me, you're not, and if you're watching this, then you probably at least know who I am. This is my second video about how I've done on various challenges for the week. Now, there's a good chance that you noticed that this week I haven't done a daily post on, well, anywhere, saying how many words I've written that day or anything like that. Basic reason for this is that I'm posting it all, well, now, as part of this video, so I'm going to spend more time talking about what I've done and less writing it up in daily chunks. Okay, so the week starts on Sunday because Sunday's the 8th, you know, second week. Well, and this week on Sunday I did some writing, which I've done just about every day. I've been writing a kind of choose your own adventure type story, making it fit together, and I also done some fanfic. Makes just over 6,000 words in total for the day, about evenly split between the two. And I also went out and did some walking. Now, I'm not quite sure what to say here, because when I was out walking, I decided that I was going to call myself. So I've got a video of me out walking, all ready for you to watch, without me having to do anything. And there it is. Hello, me of the future again. I'm just out on a walk today and experimenting with different things my camera can do again. This time I've got both cameras from my phone turned on, so hopefully I can show you where I'm going. Not entirely sure why this would be particularly interesting, but you know, probably seen it before. That's the cathedral up there, and yeah, this is the canal that I'm walking along.
I know, I was there on Sunday.
But, well, I've done about a mile already today, so I shouldn't have to go that much further to try and, you know, get some walking distance in, and maybe I can start getting fit again. This does look kind of weird. I wish I could get the camera to record, you know, both cameras, instead of having to split it up like this. But I can't seem to find that option. So I've got this thing where you can see what I'm looking at, or see me, but I can't even do a jump cut without pausing the thing.
As bad as me, you need to say something.
This bridge is weird. I've thought it since I've been living here. Hold on just a second. Yes, I can do that. But for some reason there isn't a way for me to record both cameras at once. But since I've lived here, I've thought they've got the path under the bridge here, but the canal path continues on the other side. So if you want to, you know, you have to cross over the bridge there, but for some reason there's a railing between the between the road and the path here,
and there's another pavement on the other side. So if I was walking along the pavement there, and I wanted to go down onto that canal path, I'd have to go right the way up there. I always wonder why they designed it like that. So, I guess somebody could have lost thought into these things. Not going to stop at the pub today. I'm just out here for the exercise. Bit more than last week, because I forgot what I was going to say now. Will I be able to cut that out? You know, put some music over this bit or something? I don't know. But yeah, this is mostly just me experimenting with the camera to see what I can make it do. My phone just spoke to me to say that's a mile, so I'm not doing too badly there. I have no idea if that'll come out on the video or not. In fact, I've got no idea if you can actually hear me, but yeah.
Sadly, we can.
This is a bit of the canal path. My target for walking this week is going to be different from what it was previously. Last week I said I was just going to do walking a mile every day, which is still my basic challenge, but I think once a week I'm going to try and beat my average for the year so far. I might play around with the exact numbers, but at the moment I've got a little graph telling me that this week I should be aiming to go over 1.8 miles at least once. I think it says 1.81. So I'm going to try and do that today. And as many days as possible, I'm actually going to try and do it as a single walk rather than going out and just going to the shops or something a couple of times. So I think that makes sense. You know, one longer walk rather than a couple of little ones. So I'm going to try and hit 1.8 now, and then that's me done for the day. I have no idea where I'm up to at the moment. Can I even check when the camera's up running? Yeah. Apparently I'm on 1.18 now. So I don't need to do that much more to meet my targets. And oh yeah. That is the long of the breath of fresh air walk. Some point this year I'm gonna try and find time to, you know, do the whole thing. But anyway, I've talked too much and I'm just narrating random stuff. So, I'll see you later, I guess. And probably see me earlier. Tenses are weird when it comes to like time travel or having a conversation with someone in the future. I wonder if I can think of something I can say in the future that'll go in between the things I've said now, so that it sounds like I'm having a conversation with myself. Really, I should have scripted that in advance if I was going to do that, but who knows, maybe I'll script it in advance in the future. And yet again, we have language making that sound really weird. Okay, bye.
Finally, that took long enough. He goes on a bit, doesn't he? But, yeah. That dealt with for this week. A phone call from myself. And hopefully we won't have to deal with them. Okay, then.
Hey, past me?
I just missed
it. You want to check out today? The grey's gone. So, we've actually got quite a lot of sun. So now the only problem is that the sun's in my eyes. So, you know, it's only tomorrow. If you want to check this out, then happy to trade places. Oh, and see me in the future putting all these videos together. Sorry for all the awkward pauses, that's probably making it very difficult to try and think of something just the right length to say in those 30 seconds, like we're having a conversation. Because I do think that's going to be a pretty difficult thing to do. Anyway, I'm out walking, having lunch. And talking to myself, which is surprisingly entertaining.
Well, to you, maybe.
And look, we have blue skies for a change. Unfortunately, that doesn't actually mean it's any warmer, it's just, you know, bluer. Anyway, see you tomorrow, yesterday, sometime this week, whichever.
Goodbye and good... Oh, gone. Well, anyway. That was Sunday with a little bit of Monday mixed in because, you know, these guys aren't very good at time management. So, then on to the rest of Monday. What else have I done on Monday? Well, mostly writing and nearly all of it fanfic. 4,500 words, and finally finished a story that's taken me nearly half a month, that's coming at 56,000 words. That's one chapter that's a spin-off from my long-running fanfic. Should I put a link in the comments? Should I just, you know, say the link in the comments and then not put a link there and see how many people actually notice? Because I must have heard people on YouTube say that however many times, link in the comments, and I've never checked to see if there actually is. Is this just how you be super lazy and avoid putting links in or something? No. But anyway, yeah, all I did on Monday was write fanfic, go for a bit of a walk, which was a bit sunnier, and not much else, really. Tuesday I was back on more productive work. I did 1,000 words on the Choose Your Own Adventure thing and 2,000 on a fantasy novel called A Pocket Full of Bees, which I actually started in November as my backup project for NaNoWriMo, and then kind of I haven't worked on it in quite a while, but I've picked it up again, so hopefully I'll be able to actually finish that. On that day, I went out for a walk, and I noticed that the castle's all dressed up with fancy clothes, scaffolding, whatever you call that, and also had an idea for something to motivate me to walk a little. And this is something I'm going to be doing with Twilight, one of my housemates.
basic idea was that I took a couple of photos. If you'll excuse me a minute, my laptop just locked itself and I need to make sure that it's still recording. I don't know why, because I've disabled that in three different places. But in any case, yes, I'm still recording. Hello me. Yes, that still looks like it's recording video fine. I have no idea why that just happened. But in any case, I came up with this idea where I take a couple of pictures and then Twilight goes out and tries to find where those pictures were taken and take a picture from the same place, and then she takes some and I go and try and find the picture and take the same one. We decided that she's going to take some first and then I'll try and take the same pictures. Which seems like a pretty good place to start. And so she went off to take the first picture, and then presumably the next day I'd be able to
Hello future me. Sorry to call unexpectedly, but...
We just had this conversation.
No. See, this is me calling from Wednesday. And I just wanted to let you know I've got a new challenge. It was a random idea that we've set up with... Well, me and Twilight. She's taken a picture from somewhere around town. And I'm going to try and find the same place and take the same picture. And I think that should be a pretty interesting thing to attempt. Unfortunately, the lack of light in the picture means there's not many clues, which I'm hoping will mean that it's actually a challenge. So, pictures. Just run across there before the lights change. I'm actually quite surprised how blue the sky appears in this selfie thing. I really look at glancing down at the screen occasionally, but hopefully you can still see me. Just got waved at by somebody. I'm not sure who it was. Possibly the Mormons. But anyway, yeah, those pictures, I'm trying to find where those were taken, and see if I can find a nice picture there myself. And hopefully I'll have enough light left to be able to tell for sure that I've got the right place. And then after I've done that, I'm going to find another picture for Twilight. I'm going to try and make it one within a mile of home, so it's not that hard to find, although a circle a mile in radius is still a pretty large area. So all I've got to do now is well, figure out where that picture is, I suppose. And obviously that's a bit harder because I've got the camera up on my screen right now, so I can't actually look at the pictures. I've got them on my laptop, but that's no help because that's, you know, not in front of me. I looked at them before I came out, but didn't give that much thought to where the pictures actually are, unless... Is it somewhere around here?
You know, the picture you're trying to replicate is landscape. I think that's good enough. Anyway, as I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted, we came up with this idea for a challenge that we're going to do tomorrow with me trying to take these pictures that Twilight's taken. And then after I... Oh, well, yeah, you've already seen that. But anyway, I've, you know, written some stuff, been for a walk, taken some pictures. That's about all of my day. Wednesday, again, 1,000 words on A Pocket Full of Bees, 2,700-ish on the Choose Your Own Adventure thing. I did show Twilight the picture that I'd taken, but she didn't think it was quite close enough to the original because there's clock tower that's visible on her picture that's not on mine. So I went out and did another version, and I got the other picture as well. And I'm playing with some interactive stuff this week. So if I should be able to put the two pictures on top of each other, then if you wave your mouse left and right over the dividing line, you'll be able to see how the two pictures compare. That not it works fine for me. Anyway, and after I'd done that on the same walk, because I said I was going to do that, I said I was going to take pictures within a mile of home and on the same walk that I got hers, I came up with these two, hoping that my video editing skills are now good enough to display two pictures on the screen at the same time. Thursday wasn't such a good day. I ended up starting to panic a bit in the morning and didn't get that much done until later on. In the morning I did do some planning and coding for the Choose Your Own Adventure thing, writing a little chunk of Perl code which should decide which order the chapters will come in the final version, according to a pretty neat graph, which there should be space for up here somewhere. So that was about 500 words, but most of it was on the plan. There were 1,000 words later on in the evening, and 2,500 on A Pocket Full of Bees. And I also made some progress on a thing called the Eowyn Challenge, which is basically, somebody's gone through The Lord of the Rings making a list of how far the characters travelled in total, up to certain points. This year, on the 1st of January, I started following Strider's path, which I think means I start at Bree. And on Thursday, I left Chetwood. And it's so long since I've read the books that I can't actually remember which bit that is, but it's the first mini milestone on the route. So that means I'm not doing too badly on the walking thing. Friday, 1,000 words on the Choose Your Own Adventure thing, 2,000 on a pocket full of bees, and I finished reading a book. The book I finished reading is this one, The Silk. And it's a pretty interesting book. I really should have muted my phone first, but I'm not going to re-record all this. Yeah, it's an interesting book. It's about a psychic girl who's been keeping her gift secret because she didn't want people to laugh at her. But when she sees a serial killer's face, she knows she has to go to the police and try and help somehow. And, you know, tension slowly builds. She gets to know these cops, some of whom are good people, some of whom are very mean, but presumably working for the good guys. And, yeah, all builds up to a big final climax. I think it's a pretty good book. You can identify with the characters. You know, learn a fair bit about the main character's past. Don't know that much about the supporting characters yet, but as this is the first book in a series, I assume that we're going to get into a bit more of their background and motivations in future books, which I'm looking forward to reading. About the only thing that put me off, really, was that it's written in the present tense, which seems to surprise me every time I pick it up, even if I've been reading it for nearly a week. I never managed to get the hang of books written in the present tense. It just seems weird to me. But, you know, that's not a bad thing. It's just me being weird. So, yeah, this is Soul Catcher. I recommend it. Check it out. And then after Thursday, Friday. No, I'm losing track of the days of the week. But anyway, yeah, I've been having a panic in the morning, which has been mostly stopping me working. But hopefully I can get over that. I don't really know why. And I've started reading a new book, which is this one, and hopefully I'll be able to review that, you know, same time next week, assuming I've finished it. Oh yeah, and one of the things I've been doing this year is a thing called Selfie Project that one of my friends shared with me. The idea is that you set an alarm and then at the same time, same day every week, you take a photo of yourself, and at the end of the year you put it together into a 50 frame stop motion thing. I thought that sounds like a nice idea, but every week isn't, you know, it's quite a long time, and that means you don't get that many pictures. So I've decided I'm going to do it every 3 days. So in the first 2 weeks of the year, that means that I've got 5 pictures already. Yeah, stop motion animation, you can't actually tell which order they're in because I look so similar in all of them. But like, by the end of the year, my beard will probably have grown or something and I'll look a bit different. So there'll be some kind of progression from the beginning to the end. I wonder if you'll be able to see it. But, well, all those other things. Basically, through the week, I have managed to work 30 hours and I have managed to keep my total over 30 at the end of every day. So every day, the last 7 days total is 40 hours working. I've written 25,715 words, walked a total of 21.47 miles, and read one and a bit books. I think that means that I'm doing pretty well with all of the points. So, I guess this is time for me to sign off and hope the video wasn't too boring, and hope that next time I don't have any annoying phone calls from myself to contend with, which are going to make video editing really difficult. And that's something else I want to comment on, because I think I finally got the hang of the app I'm using for video editing. So, I'll be trying all kinds of new things, and this video will probably look terrible. If you've stuck it out this far, thank you. Please comment. Has it finished yet? Has it stopped?